and welcome to season 3 of In the Black, D-Freeze Podcast. I'm Tamika Stembridge, co-host here with my co-host, Dr. Sorries, our CEO and founder of the D-Free Financial Freedom Movement.
Welcome, welcome, welcome everybody. Tamika, I'm so excited about this segment of the In the Black Podcast because it was home ownership that got me in the black. And as you know, I inherited my first house from my grandmother. And our guest today helps people from every background and at every income level become homeowners. And I love him, and I'm happy to be with you today to speak to him.
Yes, so our guest is Mr. Milt Sharp. He's the president of eHome America. He has been helping people for years to figure out the home buying process, both getting into your home, what to do when you get the house, how to get out of foreclosure. And he's doing this for the most part digitally. And so I'm excited to have Milt on the line. How are you?
I'm fantastic. And it's a pleasure to be joining you all today to be able to share more about ways on how we can assist first-time homeowners in moving into home ownership and building wealth.
Fast forward now to eHome America. What I like about Milt, Tamika, is what he's done is take his social commitment, his passion for empowerment, and combined it with technology to use technology in a way that has a sustainable business model, but also that has an empowerment element. Talk about eHome America and how you got involved and what it is.
Yes, eHome America is an online educational platform designed to assist first-time home buyers in understanding the process and the road of moving into home ownership. It's Adam Smith economics in the sense that the educated consumer is always going to be the best consumer. And for many families, their purchase of a home is going to be the largest financial transaction they've ever made in their lives. And to be able to navigate that process requires a lot of information. Many first-time home buyers aren't coming from households of folks who have owned homes before them, and so they're going through this process and they're struggling. And so their ability to better understand the process and have access to a trusted advisor who can assist them becomes key and vital. It's useful for not only the consumer, but also for the lender and others who are part of this process, because the more educated they are, the faster they can move through this process, and everybody wins in that particular scenario. eHome is available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, provided that someone has an internet connection and can get access to it through either a smartphone, a tablet, or a PC. They're able to go through it at the pace that's convenient for them. So what's really appealing to this is that there's no more having to give up nights and weekends to attend first-time homebuyer education classes. You could go to work, and if you commuted to work, possibly do the course on the bus or on the train while you're riding in, get to work and do work and break for lunch and get on your tablet and pick up where you left off at, go home that evening, put the kids down and have a little bit more time and pick back up on your computer. Eventually working your way through the many quizzes and learning checks that we have, as well as the audio and visual things through different media ways of engaging adult learners to make the process one that's, you know, that we hear from our consumers. 95% of the folks who go through our course are extremely satisfied with the experience they have, and certainly look forward to now moving through the home buying process better prepared. We're in all 50 states, including Puerto Rico, Guam, and the Virgin Islands, and I have over 500 nonprofit partners throughout the entire country. Just this last year alone, we had over 90,000 folks go through our program, and cumulatively, I've helped over 500,000 first-time home buyers move into home ownership. So I'm, again, as you mentioned earlier, socially proud of the work that I've been able to do in this space as a social entrepreneur.
A color, a number, I'm more than my credit score. But a low score means a closed door. Higher interest rates for cars and mortgages. But change is easier than we think. With Credit Builder Plus, a simple loan can build your credit, so we can all get to where we want to be. Green. Let's get to green together.
So Tamika, in our curriculum, we emphasize to D3 participants that they should consider home ownership. Not because home ownership is for everybody, but we really do want everybody to consider it so that if you are not a homeowner, you've decided not to be one. My question is, based on your knowledge of eHome and your knowledge, should someone complete the D3 curriculum before they do eHome America? Is it something they can do at the same time?
Yeah, I was going to ask the same thing.
What do you think?
I would say my recommendation would be to move through the D3 curriculum in the beginning. Building your financial capability, just one of those many symptoms, if you will, for a financially capable person is, as you mentioned earlier, the decision to purchase a home or not. We have content within our curriculum that helps folks come to that decision as well, but oftentimes building their financial muscles, building and paying down debt, increasing their savings and ensuring their ratios are in place is a good start, much of which you all helped build in the D3 curriculum. And so as they're moving down that path, there then becomes a decision, is home ownership right for me? At that time, the education that eHome America offers is going to be its most potent.
Okay, so it sounds like something we should, of course, share with the world, but
definitely
specifically, look at it within the context of our Train the Trainer and our curriculum and our partners who are already involved in D3. Yeah, that's cool.
And keeping in mind that people are in different places in the process also. There's some folks who are ready to go, and so their introduction to D3 may move them into eHome almost immediately, given where they are.
Right.
There's that fluidness in it as well.
I was going to say, forgive me for feeling absent on the podcast, but I'm just sitting here and I'm thoroughly impressed with the technology you have here. Can you talk a little bit about the connection to, local counseling agencies? I'm going through the application process myself, and they're asking me about, picking some place in my state and what does that look like? Can you talk to us a little bit about the relationship between the educational components of eHome America and what the other the opportunities that I'm opened up to when I participate in the course.
Right. So what I'll say is, the education is potent, but it's extremely potent when it's connected with a HUD-approved housing counseling agency.
Did you say potent or impotent? Did you say potent? I'm sorry, go ahead.
So eHome has partnered with HUD-approved housing counseling agencies throughout the country because we feel that it's important that after a consumer has gotten access to our education, that they have the opportunity to possibly ask additional questions or get some additional assistance and guidance from a HUD-approved housing counseling agency, preferably someone in close proximity to where they live. So when an individual signs up for eHome, they're then prompted to identify the state where they're located in the county because we assign our nonprofit area, geographical areas, and we'd like for a consumer to be able to access a counseling agency that's in close proximity to them. Maybe there's the desire to have their follow-up done face-to-face, so we certainly want to have them have that option. A lot of the follow-up is done telephonically, but the additional plus to that is by engaging with an organization that's in close proximity to where the consumer is, they also may be able to identify additional resources beyond what eHome America has to offer, particularly if an individual is looking to buy somewhere, if they're looking to get access to down payment closing cost assistance programs, it may be programs specific to possibly the municipality where they're in. We would not know that on a national level.
Yeah.
That is information that belongs on the local level and is delivered by the nonprofit organizations who we partner with that can share that additional information and assist consumers as well.
When I grow up,
I want to be a billionaire.
Billionaire.
What if we were all billionaires?
That looks like legacy.
Investment.
Property.
That looks like me.
But there's a first step to this.
You've got to get debt free.
You got to join the $1 Billion Challenge.
the Billion Dollar Challenge.
Yes, today.
We'll be waiting. We're building billionaires.
So let me walk through this a little slowly. First of all, the eHome America offers an online course, and that online course is HUD approved, correct?
That is correct.
Okay, so when I finish the course, I download a certificate, I take that to a HUD approved counseling agency, and for those who don't know, the Federal Department of Housing and Urban Development will approve a nonprofit organization, and that approval empowers that organization to help people who are in foreclosure, to help first-time home buyers, to do counseling for people who may be having trouble or sorting through questions. And they also are connected to banks. And you heard Milt talk about down payment assistance. I know a family that got $15,000 that completed the program, went to the agency, and the bank gave them literally a gift of $15,000 to help them get into their new house. Now, these are first-time home buyers. So Milt, that's the process. Before I get into the fees, let me ask, suppose I've already owned a house. Does eHome America have anything in its curriculum or anything in its portfolio to help people who already owned a house? For instance, the first time I built a house, it was not my first home, but it was my first time building a house, and it was a whole different experience than just buying a house. Talk to us about people who may not be first-time home buyers, but who could benefit from some of your resources.
Right. No, absolutely. And I'll back up, though, just in regards to the down payment assistance.
Yeah.
You know, eHome has within it a search engine that allows for an individual who's going through the curriculum to put in their unique characteristics and demographic information, and it will identify down payment assistance programs that they may qualify for, that eHome is approved for. So that certificate, once you've completed it, you've already begun the process and now have identified down payment assistance programs that are out there.
Excellent.
Through our curriculum and our partnerships throughout the country, there are over 1,500 down payment assistance programs that eHome is approved for and is accessible through our search engine within the actual curriculum. So that is an additional value add for consumers who go through eHome and are looking to get access to down payment assistance programs. We can tell you where they are.
That's excellent.
They may also be in addition to one that you may know also. Now, in terms of your question for existing homeowners, outside of providing education on potential first-time home buyers, we do have a post-purchase course that we make available to consumers as well. And this is after they become a first-time homeowner. You can imagine in owning a home, now there was a process that you needed to do to prepare to buy the house. But now there's maintaining the home and the financial position that you need to maintain in order to ensure that you're saving for possible enhancements and things that will have to be made to the home, upgrades, et cetera. But there's also now the commitment as a first-time home buyer to your community. So there's the civic involvement, the civic association that comes along with it. So our post-purchase program is centered around folks who are transitioning into home ownership, the things that they'll need to know to maintain their homes financially, but as well as their participant as a community in the communities that they are now, as we would say, fellow investors with the other homeowners who they share that neighborhood with.
Yeah, that's great. You know, we talk about the wealth gap a lot, Tamika, and African-Americans have about 1/20th of the wealth of white Americans, but of that 1/20th, over half of our assets and our wealth is in real estate.
Right.
And so historically, black people have been able to use real estate to accrue wealth, and of course God is not making any more land, so real estate is a good investment. There are peaks and valleys, but the reality is real estate is a good investment, and home ownership does more than just provide a place to put your money, but also it's a place that you own. It's your own space. You can leave it as a legacy. And so we're high on home ownership. You know, Milt, our D-Free movement talked about being free from debt delinquencies and deficits. so that we can be free to make deposits on dividends and have our names on deeds. And the deeds are deeds, physical deeds, right. not deeds and in activities, but, but deeds on property. We want to own property.
That's right.
So this is great. So I think you are one of our key partners, which means that people can access eHome America right through the D-Free website, correct?
That's correct, absolutely.
And we actually call you one of the D-Free solutions. And so that what D-Free solutions is basically a nice way of saying these are our partners that we trust who can get you to reach one of the goals that we're helping you aspire to reach. And so I want to thank you for your years of service to our communities.
Because thank you.
Everything you've done since I've known you has been in service to other people. And I want to thank you for trusting D-Free to be a carrier of your brand and a sharer in your mission.
No, absolutely. I think it is the absolute best partnership. I say this oftentimes, you know, eHome America as an educational platform provides folks with the knowledge and skills that they need in order to navigate this process. But that doesn't always guarantee success. It requires the magical part that makes that stick, which is faith and belief. And that faith and belief is what helps to make those attitudinal and behavioral changes that make those knowledge and skills potent. But I have a lot of folks who will look to go and get this information, but if they're not motivated, they don't have the faith to overcome some of the obstacles that are going to present themselves. Because, you know, I don't have to tell you, you know, just as well as I do, some folks' credit out here is jacked up. And when they look at what they're going to have to do to get it right, they're going to have some belief and faith that this thing can come together. And I believe that what D-Free offers outside of just partnering with us to give folks the knowledge and skills that they need to accomplish this is also connected with the power of faith. And I don't have to tell you, faith is extremely powerful.
Well, that's what we do. We say our secret sauce is giving people the motivation and the faith they need to take advantage of resources. So thank you. Thank you, Milt. You can go to the D-Free website, mydfree.org, and just click D-Free Solutions. Mm-hmm. And under D-Free Solutions, you'll find eHome America. Go right in. You can sign up for the course. The benefits are extraordinary. And the small, very small fee that's attached to the course is simply a deposit on the benefits that you'll receive, many of which can be financial if you complete the course and follow the process. So thank you. Thank you, Tamika, for helping us connect with Milt. And thanks to the team that has constructed the partnership and the D-Free Solutions technology. And thank you, Milt, for building a great platform.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you for listening to the D-Free in the Black podcast. Our goal is that you stay in the black, which means that you should subscribe to the podcast, go to the website, join the $1 Billion Challenge, become a part of the D-Free Financial Freedom Movement.